Hi everyone, welcome to day 6 of the 15-day songwriting challenge. Today we're going to be talking about how to write a chord progression. For the first part of the video, I'm going to go through simple chord progressions, and then for the second part, I'm going to go a little more into depth into some interesting chord progressions that you can use for your songs. So be sure to download the free template down below. There's also a list of examples of chord progressions that you can use, and if you're over on Patreon, then you can download the extra templates and examples over there. Also, be sure to subscribe because there are new videos coming every day for the songwriting challenge. So a chord progression is the order that the chords are played in. In each key, there are 7 chords that are natural to that key, and some of the chords are more important than the other chords. So in this video, we're going to be talking about chord progressions in C major, and the most important chord in C, of course, is C. So C is kind of like your home. It's usually where the song is going to start, and it's usually where the song is going to finish. And then other important chords in C are F and G, and these chords are important because they're usually the chords that lead back to C. So oftentimes in your chord progressions, you're going to see an F chord at the end or a G chord at the end right before you go back to the C chord. So funny enough, some songs only will use just one chord. And if you're in C major, that chord would be your C chord. So here's the C chord. And then the whole song is just played over that one chord. There are some songs that only use 2 chords, and in C major, some common progressions that use 2 chords would be C and F. Or you would have C and G. So one of those chord progressions would repeat throughout the whole song. If you do write a song that uses just 1 or 2 chords, it might give the song sort of like a static feel since you're not going many places, but this can be really cool. Actually, it's a good strategy if you want to write something that's kind of peaceful and calm. It's a really good, nice sound for that kind of a song. Then you can also write songs that use 3 chords. So those chords usually would be C, F, and G. And then you can also mix up these chords, so maybe you would have C, G, and F. Or maybe G, F, C. Or F, G, C. Or even C, F, G, and F. So there are still just 3 harmonies in that progression. So the fewer chords you have and the more repetition there is in your song, the easier it's going to be for your listener to focus in on the lyrics and the story, just because there's not a whole lot of harmonic stuff to distract them. So if you have a lot of text, or if your song is more of a storytelling kind of song, then you might want to keep the chord progression pretty simple. And then it's really common to hear about this 4 chord progression. So now we need to add in one more important chord for the key of C major, and that chord is A minor. This chord is important, but it's not as important as the other 3 chords that we already talked about. So when you throw this one in though, you can make a whole bunch of different combinations for your chord progressions. So one combination you could have is C, G, A minor, and F. You could also do C, A minor, F, and G. And then one more is C, F, A minor, G. There's a whole bunch of different combinations that you can use. And these 4 chords are heard all over in pop music. So now let's go a little bit into some music theory. So you may have heard before the concept of 1-4-5. And in C major, this is actually talking about those chords, C, F, and G, that we just talked about. But the 1-4-5 is written in Roman numerals. I'm not sure why we use Roman numerals. I think it's just one of those things that is, and it just is. So you're gonna see uppercase Roman numerals for major chords, and then lowercase numerals for minor chords. So in C major, you have the C as the 1 chord, F as the 4 chord, and G as the 5 chord. C is a really common key, and there are 12 different keys altogether. So another common key would be G. Our 1, 4, 5, and G would be G, C, and D. You can do this in all 12 keys, and it makes it easier to play in any of them. So one thing you can do to make your chord progressions more interesting is to borrow chords from other keys. So in C major, we have 7 chords that are natural to C. Those chords are C, D minor, E minor, F, G, A minor, and B diminished. So then a borrowed chord would be any chord that wasn't any of these chords. There are a few different types of borrowed chords. The first one we're going to talk about is the 5 chord from a different key. So here's a chord progression that uses that kind of borrowed chord. We have C, then E, then A minor, and G. So C is the 1 chord, we're going to skip over E, then A minor is the 6th chord, and G is our 5 chord. So that E chord is the one that is the borrowed chord, because that's not typically found in C major. This E chord is the 5 chord in the key of A minor. That's why the A minor is coming right after it too. Typically, the 5 chord is going to lead to the chord of the key that it's borrowed from. So here's that C, the 1 chord, then the 5 of 6, then the 6 chord, and then the G chord. So this progression borrowed the 5 chord from the key of the 6th chord, but you can borrow 5 chords from any key. So here's another chord progression. We have C, F, then D, and G. So our C is the 1 chord, F is the 4 chord, and then the G is our 5 chord, and this D chord is the 5 chord in the key of G. So we have 1, 4, 5 of 5, and G. So this might be a lot of information. So another type of borrowed chord is the minor 4 chord, and this is a really, really nice sound. So here's a chord progression with the minor 4 chord. We have C, G, F, and then F minor. It sounds super nice. So that C chord is the 1 chord, then we have G, the 5 chord, then F, our 4 chord, and then the minor F for the minor 4 chord. So then another type of borrowed chords are flat chords. So in this progression, we have a flat chord. So here's the sound. We have C, then B flat, then F, and G. So that B flat chord is the one that isn't typically found in C major. This is a flat 7 chord. So we have the 1 chord, the flat 7, 4, and 5. So that is a basic rundown of some of the borrowed chords that you can use to make your chord progressions more interesting. I'm guessing this was a lot of information, so I'm going to leave an example sheet of chord progressions you can use that have borrowed chords in them. So if you want to write your own chord progressions, I would just suggest experimenting around and seeing what sounds good. There are some loose guidelines that you can follow. So for example, if you're in C, you might want to start on the C chord, and you might want to end the progression with an F or a G chord. If you're going to use the F chord at the end, it's going to give it a more modern pop kind of sound. And if you use the G chord at the end, it's going to be a little more like folk or classical style. And then the last thing I want to mention is that you can't copyright chord progressions, meaning that if you hear something in a song that you really like, you can go ahead and look up that chord progression and use it in one of your own songs. So good resources for this are ultimateguitar.com and also using tutorials here on YouTube. So your assignment for today is to write 3 chord progressions. The first one can be a chord progression that you liked from this video. The second one can be a chord progression from your favorite song. And then the third one can be a chord progression that you write yourself. You can also download the free template below and those examples of chord progressions to help you out. And if you're over on Patreon, you can download the extra templates and examples there. So let us know in the comments what you're going to use as your chord progression, and please like the video and subscribe. Tomorrow we're going to be talking about how to write melodies, so I will see you then. Bye!